This would be a mid-career building for I.M. Pei. He goes on to build the pyramid at the Louvre, the National Gallery in Washington, and several other really impressive buildings. There's this rather famous anecdotal story about how when the construction barricade went up around the building, that a student put graffiti on the barricade saying, "The shortest point between any two points is where Wilson Commons is." And Pei knew that well before even building the building. He knew that this was actually the gravitational center of the campus. So when you look at this building, particularly in plan, you see it's extremely simple geometry. It's a square bisected by a wide pathway, which is the atrium, and then subdividing it into a large triangle and a small triangle. It's almost a kind of diagram of his larger idea for the building, which is to create a pathway through a building connecting one hub of campus to the other, which is, of course, being Rush Rhys Library. Pei paid a tribute to the campus architecture by using bricks, but you can tell that he also wasn't beholden to the campus architecture. He wanted to do something of its time. So the brick is not the brick on the rest of the campus, and it's making a point that this is of the 1970s, and it's not apologizing for that. And I think that's where the best architecture comes from, is one that is acknowledges its context, but also is trying to say something about its time and place as well. I see this building as a kind of reminder for the university of how to think about new projects when they build them, and not to have necessarily a slavish, beholden attitude towards the kind of buildings of the Eastman Quadrangle, which are beautiful and also part of the campus's texture, but not necessarily how the whole campus should look. Pei understood that winters in Rochester are long, and he wanted to cultivate a place where you could feel like you're outdoors and feel nourished by the kind of plaza setting that you would experience, say, in a downtown in the summer. And I do think it's still very successful, and I think it's a tribute to Pei and his foresight that this building is still functioning as wonderfully as it is 40 years ago as it is today.
A production of the University of Rochester. Please visit us online and subscribe to our channel for more videos.